Hey everybody, welcome back to Head Trip Air World Tour. It's Sunday evening, November 21st, 2021, and you wouldn't know it because it's daytime in the game, but it's about 10 o'clock at night, and I figured, you know what better day to continue our journey. I decided to go simple in this little Cessna 172. We're sitting in Managua, Nicaragua, and we're going to move down on past Granada, famous city of Granada, over the lake, and on to, what did we decide? San Jose, Costa Rica. Don't know how long it'll take me, but I thought just a nice, beautiful day for a flight. And so that's kind of the plan today. I was in the mood for some of my favorite, gospel music. And so that's what we're going to do. Now, let's be honest. Let's have a face-to-face here. It's just me and you. So it's going to be a quiet, peaceful flight. And we're just going to enjoy the scenery along the way. And what else can we say? Let's hope everything goes well. And we'll kick into gear here shortly. So just sit back, buckle up, enjoy. And we'll be ready to taxi here shortly.
My eyes and the things that I can't. Say the word and there is light. Say the word and their bones rise. Every start and end hangs on your voice. For your will never returns.
Tower head trip, one ready at runway 28 east departure.
Head trip 1 altimeter, 29 decimal niner, 2 and 2 7 1 and 3. Departure to the east approved. Cleared for takeoff runway 28.
Cleared for takeoff runway 28 head trip 1.
Word made flesh you.
You
Tower head trip, one continue for east departure.
Trip 1 leaving my airspace frequency. Change approved.
Tower head trip, 1 frequency change. Approach head trip 1 is type Cessna Skyhawk. 1 mile north of Managua, 2,800 feet. Request clearance to transition Charlie airspace.
Head trip 1 approach. Squawk 2463.
Okay, looks like we've got a pretty good start up in the air. Now the only thing we need to do is start to increase a little bit of speed. So we're going to adjust the trim a little bit and get our speed up into the at least about maybe the 110 knots range. And it's going to be a pretty direct flight towards San Jose. Now, we are going to be passing, I believe, Granada up here against the coast here shortly. So we'll do a quick fly over Granada, and then it's going to be a flight over the lake. Right now, I am already forgetting what the name of the lake is. Lake Nicaragua. Pretty large lake. Very large lake, actually. So we've got a nice little trip ahead of us, but we'll try to pick up some speed and see if we can get to our destination in some type of reasonable amount of time. So hold tight and enjoy the scenery. And right below is the city of Granada, the famous city of Granada that got burned to the ground, I think, at some point in time. I should really know more about the history of that city, but I do remember it was some type of holdout back in the... No, I don't know. I don't know when it was. I shouldn't pretend to know my history, but I do know it was one of those cities that got burned down. With a sign left that said, here was Granada. So here it is, below you right now. I could certainly pull open the Wikipedia, but that'd be a little late in the coming at this point. All I know is it's got to be a pretty beautiful city to live next to this gorgeous large lake, Nicaragua. Okay, we're going to be moved to center now. We'll acknowledge the handoff.
Central America Center, head trip 14,400 feet.
Head trip 1, Central America Center, altimeter 29.92, continue as planned.
And we'll continue on.
consistent on somewhat of a straight course.
Okay, I think we've got our heading bug at least close to where it needs to be. Let's get ourselves back on track a little. Now, clearly we're going to have to go around that large volcanic island. So, I don't think we've got the height right now we need to get over it. I'm not 100% sure we'll get that height in that amount of time. So, we're going to have to probably cheat the volcano. But we can try. I just don't know if we've got the speed. See if we can tip our nose up a little bit and not lose too much speed. I still don't think we're going to get over that mountain. There's no way. I mean, I could be wrong. I've been wrong before. But in this little Cessna, it is not terribly easy to gain elevation very fast. I'll put some flaps on, see if we can give ourselves some lift. We're going to have to watch that, though, because if we lose too much speed, we're going to have to change the game plan. Yeah, I'm pretty sure that's not going to work. There's a couple of towns on this little island, so maybe that's all for the best. We can kind of browse around and see what we've got to find. Over here to our right, over there, kind of in the corner, there's, what is it, Moyojapa? I'm probably slaughtering that name. And Alta Gracia over here on this other side. Kind of a cool little island. It's a double volcano, actually, connected to the next island on over. We are gaining altitude, but I'm pretty sure that thing is going to be over 6,000 feet, probably. Guess we'll find out. Let's get behind our wing and see what we're looking at. I don't know. I mean, it looks close, but not probably close enough. Maybe. You know what? Never say never. Never say never. I don't recommend this in a real Cessna. There's no reason for it, but we'll give it a quick try. It looks like we're gonna almost skirt the top. Probably gonna feel the effect of. So we're gonna just veer off to the left here. At least we're going to try. We've got autopilot. This will be interesting. This is going to cut it close. I'm going to pull up just a little bit. That was cutting it close. Definitely. We made more altitude than I thought we were, and that was only 4,800 feet, too. I thought it was going to be another 1,000 feet. I think we can flatten out our flaps. Let's see if we can pick up our speed again. We've slowed down significantly. Autopilot's not doing us any favors at this juncture, so I'm going to turn it off until I can get the rest of that coordinated the way we want it. There we go. Let's see if we can pick up some speed. Not sure what happened there. Let's just go back into it. And let's hope we can go back into it. That would be a little bit catastrophic if we can't. Not looking great. Looks like we've frozen up just a little bit. Now there is a possibility that we're in freeze mode here. Well, that's certainly interesting. Okay, so somehow we've just frozen time. Don't know how that happened, but it did happen. So let's see if we can unfreeze. Usually it's this right here. You know, let's see if our propellers are still... Yeah, the propellers are still spinning. So usually it's just this little thing right here. Whoops. But lo and behold, it doesn't seem to be. So, let's see if we can get our flight back. It was really odd. Ghost in the machine. Trying to figure that out. Almost like... I think I know what happened. I think we're going to have to go to settings. I'm pretty sure I know what happened here. It was, where would that be? No, it's not in here. Probably in here. Some type of it's like a slew or something like that. I don't know. Time. No. Trying to figure out what it is I'm trying to simmerate. I'm gonna press R, see if that helps. Simmerate. Well, let's hope it does. Oh, there we go. Decided to solve itself, so we'll take it. I was almost worried when we lost that flight. Pretty meager road system, but it looks like there is maybe a road that traverses the very edge. Right, the very edge of the island. Which is probably a very pretty drive. Some hillside farm. Now we're getting just a little off course, so we'll self-correct. There we go again. Isn't that interesting? I'm going to click R here. See if that makes a difference. I think we're just going to have to wait for it. That's never happened before. We have a lot of confidence that we can get it back. So we'll exercise a little bit of patience. While we're waiting for it, let's just give you a quick rundown of where we're at along our journey. Here we are, right in the middle of Lake Nicaragua. Started in Managua, coming down to San Jose, which is right here. So I would say... if we're not halfway, we're getting pretty close to it. And we're almost getting to the border of Costa Rica. So, there is that. Let's try to do the same thing we did last time. Go back here to Control Options. And mess around here just a little bit. Search for rate. And there it is. And we come back. We go OK. We go back. And we resume. And there we go. Not sure, must be a bug. Looks like we got a freighter down there or some. Maybe it's just an island. I don't know what that is. Yeah, maybe it's just an island. A little teeny island. Yep, it is. Just very small. There we go. Looks like we're back on track. Pretty well. Now maybe we'll kick open the autopilot again and let it keep us on our heading course. Of course, it's going to want to do some climbing. We'll see how that goes. Play just a little bit here. We'll put our mixture all the way in. Looks like we have an airport coming up. Believe this would be San Rafael in Costa Rica. By the way, we are now in Costa Rica. You can see it on our maps here. We've just crossed the border. Left leg behind us. And actually, Upala is the one that looks like we're coming up on here. The airport in Upala. And we'll continue in this direction, passing San Rafael and then moving our way down into San Jose. Let's see if we can spot the airport down there. Airport's going to be coming at us at a perpendicular, looks like. You would think it'd be pretty easy to spot, and there it is, right down there. With runways heading off in what about we should have a runway maybe slightly 21 and I don't know 21 and 3 21 and 5 let's just see what runway numbers are down there. Test our theory here. I'm not seeing any runway numbers at all. So maybe down here we don't have the same type of designation. We'll see if we can pick up a little bit of speed. And the only way to do that when you're on autopilot is to put your nose down. I shouldn't say it's the only way, but certainly one way. We do have the mountain range coming up that we're going to have to negotiate here. Shouldn't be too much of a challenge. I mean, we're up to 400 feet, so I think we'll probably glide over top of them. Too much trouble. Once again, it'll be close, but we'll see how that goes. We'll be right back. This must be the flat part of Costa Rica. At least one of them. We are getting a little bit low on fuel, I just noticed, so I guess that's something to keep in the back of our mind. Looks like we've got about 28 minutes to our destination, so I'm still hopeful that we'll make it. See if we can see any planes around. I'm not seeing the American Airlines. Wait a minute. I really should have probably turned my landing lights off. And I really should have turned my taxi lights off. And frankly, my strobe as well. But hey. There we go. Now we're not blinding anybody. starting to have second thoughts about being able to make it over that mountain range. The question is do we need to make it over that mountain range? I'm pretty confident we do. I think we're far enough out that we're going to need to do that. Because I believe that San Jose is on the other side of that range. Quite confident about it. So the question is it feels like we need to maybe do some climbing, and now would be a good time to get started. So that'll be obviously at the expense of our speed, but let's get our nose up a little bit. Let's go up about 500 feet per minute.
To heal my broken soul.
We're down to about 20% of our fuel tank. And we have about 23 minutes on route. So it's going to be a little tight. Let's just see what other airports are around, just in case we don't make it. Alright, there's two of them. We could refuel at one of those, I suppose. See, I'm going to do a little bit of research to see what kind of runways we've got at MRAN and MRQA. Looks like we've got about a longest runway is about 2,600 feet at MRAN. Let's try the other, MRQA. Longest runway is about 2,600 feet as well, so they're not huge airports, and we're not that far from San Jose, but... goodness. We'll just have to hope that we make it. Maybe there'll be some airports that come into view a little closer. Wish I had a really good sense of these mountain ranges. It's a little tricky to figure out.
Revive, Spirit of God.
And of course, the higher we get, the better fuel economy we get, so maybe that's good that we're climbing. Probably going to take a little bit out of us to get up there. But maybe once we get up to about 9,000, 10,000 feet, maybe that'll save us a little bit on the fuel. Given us the low fuel warning, so can't say we haven't been warned. Down to about goodness. About 18% fuel. So God, we pray to you, humble ourselves again. Lord, will you hear our cry? Lord, will you hear our lay? That every eye will see. Now, we'll say this, since we've gained that much elevation, we really do need to pull back on our mixture a little bit here. Let's see if we can fix that. Just leave it right out there. Lord, will you hear our cry? Lord, will you heal our land that every eye will see? And that should conserve a little more fuel. The one who took our sin, the one who died and rose. And I think. I could be wrong. I believe the town right to the left is Ciudad Quesada. And we do have some urban population coming up as we cross this range, so if we don't make it all the way to San Jose, we'll get darn close. I think there's going to be plenty of airports that are going to be an option for us coming up. That's at least my gut feel. I'm also going to level off our flight path here. That should pick up our speed. And so we got a little friend coming the other way. Let's see if we can pick him out in the sky. It's not going to be easy. There he is, right up there. He's got to be about 30,000 feet or something. To a nice little sunset here shortly. Looks like the sun's ready to make a disappearance. Like we're getting close. We're being asked to move over to approach. So San Jose, Juan Santa Maria International, is hanging out about 3,000 feet, about 3048 feet above sea level, which is why, even though we're at 9,000 feet, we're really only about 6,000 feet above the ground, or at least we will be by the time we get to San Jose. Frankly, much closer than that, obviously. Looks like we got some high elevations hanging out with us up here. We'll drop back down when we get into the valley.
Speak to me. I'm listening.
think we're going to get our landing lights on. Not 100% sure when we're supposed to flip those, but I think it might be a good idea. Making good progress. We're about 5 minutes away. We are making great progress. So let's see what kind of directions we get from approach when we enter the airspace, which, you, as you can see, is coming right up.
Tower head trip 19,100 feet to land.
Head trip 1 Coco Tower. Altimeter 29 decimal niner 21272 at 3. Enter white base runway 07.
Okay, we've got clearance to enter the right base runway 07.
Right base runway 07 head trip.
That means we're going to be taking a right here as we enter the airspace, and then we're going to be landing from the west, coming to the east. See if we can get a visual. So I'm going to take us off of autopilot. No need for that anymore at this point in time. Trim our nose down. Put some flaps on as we come down. Slow ourselves down. drop ourselves in elevation. Landing strip is right over there. See if we need to call in base or final. I think we've got everything we need. And that's how it's done. Right in time for dusk, sunset. Let's see if we can exit the runway here. Switch over to ground, and let's find ourselves a parking spot.
121.9, head trip 1. Taxiing to gate 19er by taxiway Alpha head trip 1.
Let's get our taxi lights on. And I think we're ready to find our way to gate 19. I don't know where gate 19 is, but we can certainly look for it. Let's go ahead and bring that up. Here we are in San Jose. Let's find our... I don't know if this is going to show us the gates, but maybe one of these are. No. And there we go. It looks like it's got some gate information, possibly. A9. 30A. 3A. 2B. 12, 13. We're so close. There it is. Anybody seeing 19? I'm certainly not seeing 19. Maybe down here. 11, 12, 8. There's the domestic ramps. He stands. Well, let's just go find ourselves a decent spot house at. Not sure where 19 is.
I need to see you.
We'll figure it out.
Here. I need to know you're in control. When my heart is torn wide open, I will trust, I will remember. I need to hear your voice speaking to silence all my doubts. Your word won't return empty. You will break through every darkness.
Looks like we've got, from what I can tell, the Pleiades just ready to peek up over top of the mountains.
Rising above my greatest fears.
I think we'll keep going down. See if we can find better taxi or parking options down here. Looks like we got a couple jets down here. Looks like we got fuel off to the left, and I think that's what we're going to do. I think we're going to move over to the fuel and fuel up for our next trip. Maybe this isn't fuel, maybe this is just air, but no. Get us back up to about 60%. There we go. And at that point, I think we're ready to call it a trip. So let's shut down the vehicle. We'll let ground services come pick us up at a later time. Looks like we don't have any pushback anyways. We've got a pushback over there, but I'm not sure he's coming over to help us. This guy looks like he is busy contemplating the mysteries of the universe. So, I don't know, maybe he's making his way over here. But I'm pretty sure he's not. Yep. So, let's just call this. Let's come down. Shut off the engine, number one. I might need a flashlight. We'll set the parking brake. Flip our nav and taxi, land, and beacon off. Turn off avionics. Log the flight hours. And we'll call it a night. Let's see. There we go. So that was it. Nice little long trip from Managua, Nicaragua, down to San Jose, Costa Rica. How many countries does that give us on our list? We've got United States, Mexico, Guatemala, Belize, Honduras, Nicaragua, Costa Rica. I think we're up to 7 countries. Out of, let's just not count how many we have left, because it's quite a few. So anyways, hope you enjoyed a nice, relaxing, peaceful Sunday evening flight. Thanks for indulging me and letting me play just the nice gospel music tonight. And hope you had a good time. And we'll pick it up. We'll pick it up from San Jose. Keep going. And see what adventures lie ahead. So thank you for joining Head Trip Bear, and we will see you on the flip side.